Back to Fox 59 this morning. It is a bug that's native to China, India, and Vietnam, but it's made its way to the United States, first being spotted in Pennsylvania in 2014. Since then, it's spread to several states on the East Coast and in the Midwest, including here in Indiana. Mike Volz, the district manager of Davey Tree Expert Company's Indianapolis office, joins me now to share what you should know about the spotted lanternfly. Mike, thanks for coming in. I've never heard of this bug. Where in Indiana have these been spotted?
So far, mostly just in the northern counties, Huntington County, places like that. It hasn't, to my knowledge, been found in our region yet.
What time of year might Hoosiers see these lanternflies?
Right now, you would be potentially seeing the adult stage, which kind of looks like a small moth, about an inch long.
Okay.
Wings folded back, grayish with spots on it.
What plants are likely these bugs are to pop up on?
The preferred host for this insect is the tree of heaven, which is actually an invasive tree.
Right.
You could also see them on black walnuts. The biggest threat that the spotted lanternflies pose is actually to grapes.
Interesting. So this could affect the wine industry for those who produce a lot of wine, and I know that we do have vineyards here in the state as well. Tell us about the signs and symptoms that spotted lanternflies has an effect on trees specifically.
Well, they're prolific feeders. They'll feed in mass. They will suck the juices out of the trees, the leaves and the twigs, and then all that has to go somewhere, so it drips down and in this form called honeydew, which can leave it a sticky substance that can leave quite a mess.
Oh, gross.
Yes, it's absolutely disgusting.
Do they die off after they do all of that?
No, after they feed, they're going to mate and lay eggs.
Oh,
and
geez.
That's a really important thing to scout for, is egg masses. The problem is they're really hard to see.
They're hard to see because they're so small.
They actually look like a smattering of mud.
Interesting.
And they can lay it on the trunks of trees, on lawn furniture, on cars, campers. It's a little difficult to spot them.
So for people who are, you know, they go out and they see something for the first time like this, it would be a shock to them to see. Could they specifically say that's what that is?
It might be hard to actually figure out what it is. Like I said, it could look like a spot of mud.
So what should they do if they do see something like that and determine, okay, this might be this lanternfly?
You can, if you can actually find out that it is a lanternfly egg mass, or if you think you find an adult, you could contact the DNR exotic hotline, basically to report a sighting.
Department of Natural Resources, definitely. Mike, thank you so much for coming on this morning and telling us about this new bug that we have to look out for. Really do appreciate it so much. For more information on spotted lanternflies, visit fox59.com/links. I know